Hello and welcome kids once again to your science classes of grade 4. And in this part of the video kids, I am going to revise chapter number 6 of your science course book. And the name of the chapter is Plants the Producers, in which we have already studied about leaf, food preparation in plants, interdependence of plants and animals. So I am going to revise the keywords, book exercises, as well as the question answer of this chapter. So the first keyword, it is given in page number 5. Sorry, the first book exercise is given in page number 50 of my science book. That is, let's recall. So write T for true and F for false statement. So you have to mention true and false. So first is, plants can make their own food. Yes, it is a true statement. That's why the plants are known as producers. Second, all plants depend on animals for food. It is false statement. By the way, all the animals, all the herbivorous animals, they depend on plants for food. Plants are not dependent on animals for food. So it is a false statement. Third, stomata are present on the underside of a leaf. Yes, it is a true statement. Fourth, leaves make food for a plant. Yes, it is also a true statement. Fifth, leaves take in oxygen through stomata to make food for the plant. It is a false statement because leaves take in carbon dioxide gas to make food for the plant and they release out oxygen gas. Okay. The next thing is about the keywords that is given in the let's memorize section. That is only the keywords and it is given in page number 52 of my science book. So the first keyword is about producers. So green plants that can make their own food are called producers. Green plants are only known by the name producers because they can make their own food by themselves. Second is leaf blade. Broad flat part of a leaf is called the leaf blade. Yes, you have seen in the diagram also. So this is the broad flat part of the leaf. The chauda or flat part hota hai leaf ka jo aapko aam taur pe nazar aata hai. So that is known by the name leaf blade. Okay. Next is the stomata. Tiny holes present on the underside of a leaf are called stomata. जो बहुत छोटे छोटे tiny means very small. So बहुत छोटे छोटे जो holes present होते हैं पत्तों के नीचे, ठीक है, underside on the lower surface of the leaf. They are known by the term stomata. Next is chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is a green substance present in leaves. Yes, in the leaves, the green colored substance, chlorophyll is present. Okay? And that too, due to that chlorophyll only, the leaves appear green in color. And chlorophyll is also important for completing the process of photosynthesis. Next is photosynthesis. The process by which green plants make their own food in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is that process by which the green plants, they are able to make their own food in the presence of sunlight. Sunlight presence is important. Okay. So that is the definition of photosynthesis. Next is food chain. A chain of organisms that shows that each organism in the chain depends on the lower organism for its food is known as food chain. Food chain can be understood by this diagram. In this diagram, you can see the chain or sequence of living organisms. And each organism in this chain is dependent on its lower organism for its food. For example, if we talk about deer, plants, they are the producers. So they are at the first number. Okay, they are at the first level of the food chain. They are not dependent on any of the animals for their food. But yes, herbivores, they are on the second level of the food chain. And they are dependent on their lower organism, that is the green plants, grass, for their food. Similarly, the carnivores animals or lion, they are dependent on herbivores for their food because these animals are flesh eaters. Okay, so they are dependent on the lower organism, the organism prior to them for their food requirement. So this chain sequence is known as food chain. Okay. Next is the book exercises. Pick the correct answer. First is, which of the following are producers? Plants, animals, men, birds. So green plants, they are the producers because they can make their own food. Second, green colored substance present in leaves is stomata, veins, lamina, chlorophyll. So green colored substance present in leaves is known by the term chlorophyll. Third, the broad flat part of a leaf is called leaf blade, main vein, stomata, starch. So the broad flat part of a leaf is known as leaf blade. Fourth, plants give out oxygen, carbon dioxide, sunlight, chlorophyll. So when the plants do photosynthesis, they are giving out the gas that is named as oxygen. Fifth, food factory of a plant is root, fruit, flower, leaf. So food factory or kitchen of a plant is leaf. Okay. Next is fill in the blanks with the correct words. Already the words are given, so we have to choose the correct word and fill the blanks. First, leaves are dash due to the presence of chlorophyll. Green, yellow, red. Then we know that presence of chlorophyll gives green color to the leaves. Okay, so green will be the correct answer. Next, dash transport food, water and minerals to and from the leaf. Veins, roots, flowers. So veins, the thin tube-like structures, okay, that is present in the leaves, they only does the function, they only transport food, water and minerals to and from the leaf. पत्तों तक पहुंचाते हैं और पत्तों में जब खाना प्रिपेयर हो जाता है लीव्स में, देन दोज प्रिपेयर्ड फूड इज ऑल्सो ट्रांसपोर्टेड बाय द वेन्स टू डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट. थर्ड, डैश हेल्प द प्लांट टू ब्रीद. स्टोमेटा, वेन्स, रूट. सो स्टोमेटा, दे आर द टाइनी टाइनी होल्स और टाइनी पोर्स प्रेजेंट ऑन द अंडर साइड ऑफ द लीव विच हेल्प द प्लांट टू ब्रीद. नेक्स्ट, एक्स्ट्रा फूड इज स्टोर्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डैश. Simple sugar, starch, iodine. So extra food which is being prepared in the plants, they are stored in the form of starch. Starch is the chemical substance in the form of which the extra food prepared in the plant is getting stored in different parts of the plant like root, stem, leaves, seeds, etc. Fifth, roots absorb water and minerals from the dash. Soil, air, soil, sun. So roots absorb water and minerals from the soil because generally the roots are growing in the soil. Okay? Under the earth surface, under the ground. Question number C is, name the following. First is the substance that makes leaves green. So that substance name is chlorophyll. C-H-L-O, chlorophyll, P-H-Y-L-L. Second, the gas absorbed by plants for photosynthesis. So for completing the process of photosynthesis, plants are absorbing the gas, carbon dioxide gas, okay, from the atmosphere. So the gas name is carbon dioxide, which the plants are taking in, okay, for doing the process of photosynthesis. And meanwhile, they are releasing out, they are giving out oxygen gas in the atmosphere, which we human beings, we all the animals, those who are living beings, they take in for their breathing. Third, the food factory or kitchen of a plant, that is the leaves. If there are so many leaves, then we call it leaves. If there is a single leaf, then it is written as L-E-A-F, leaf, okay. So the food factory or kitchen of a plant is its leaf or leaves. Fourth, any three parts where food is stored in plants. So those three parts may be root, stem, leaves. So these are some of the plant parts where the extra food prepared in the plant is getting stored, okay, in the form of starch. Fifth, the process by which plants make their own food, that process is termed as photosynthesis, okay. Now kids, there is answer the following questions which I am going to discuss with you. So, this is chapter number 6, Plants the Producers, question answers. First question is, what is chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is a green substance present in leaves. Chlorophyll kya hai? Toh wohi green substance hai jo patto mein present hota hai. Theek hai? Second, what is photosynthesis? So, answer is, the process by which green plants make their own food in the presence of sunlight is called photosynthesis. वो प्रोसेस जिससे कि जो हरे पेड़ पौधे हैं वो अपना खुद का खाना बनाते हैं बट इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट, बिकॉज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सनलाइट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अकम्प्लिश द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस. ओके, फोटो मीन्स होती है लाइट. ओके, सिंथेसिस मीन्स टू मेक समथिंग. सो बाय यूजिंग द सनलाइट द ग्रीन प्लांट्स दे आर प्रिपेयरिंग देयर ओन फूड एंड दैट प्रोसेस इज ओनली टर्म्ड एज फोटोसिंथेसिस. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, हु आर प्रोड्यूसर्स? सो ग्रीन प्लांट्स मेक देयर ओन फूड सो दे आर कॉल्ड प्रोड्यूसर्स. Who are producers? So green plants, green trees on this planet Earth, they are only known by the term producers because they can make their own food. वो अपना खाना खुद बना सकते हैं. That's why green plants are termed as producers also. Next is, what are the functions of a leaf? So a leaf helps a plant to. एक पत्ता जो है अपने इस पौधे को मदद करता है breathe through stomata because stomata are the tiny pores, tiny holes which are present on the underside of a leaf. And the leaf is only known as the kitchen or the food factory of the plant because leaf prepare food by the process of photosynthesis. So these are the two functions of leaves, that a leaf helps a plant to breathe through stomata and make food. Okay, so these are the functions of leaf. Next question is, draw a well-labeled diagram of a leaf. So this question is, answer is to be done by the students themselves. Take help from science book, page number 48, diagram of parts of a leaf. So kids, in my science book, this diagram is given in page number 48. Let me show you this diagram. All the diagram works are very important. So this is the diagram given in page number 48 of my science book. Okay, this is the diagram of parts of a leaf. Okay, and this is the main vein, this is the side vein, and this is the flat broad part of a leaf, that is known as leaf plate. Okay, so this diagram you have to draw along with answer number 5. Okay, next question is, how are plants and animals interdependent? Plants or animals ek dusre pe dependent kaise hain? How they are interdependent? Okay, interdependent means how plants, in what way the plants, they are dependent on the animals, and in what way the animals, they are dependent on the plants. So answer is, plants are producers. Okay, animals depend directly or indirectly on plants for their food. Plants jo hai wo producers hain because they can make their own food, but some of the animals, they are dependent directly on the plants, and these animals are herbivores, because herbivores are plant eaters. They can eat plant parts, grass, leaves. Okay, and some animals, they are indirectly dependent on plant for their food, because these animals are carnivores. Carnivores are flesh eaters. They need the flesh of other animals, other herbivores to eat. But herbivores will survive when it will eat the green plants, grasses, plant products. Okay, so whether it is a herbivore, whether it is a carnivore, both are directly or indirectly dependent on plants for their food. Okay, herbivores eat plants and carnivores eat herbivores. Thus, a chain called food chain exists in nature. Exist means present. तो इस तरीके से एक food chain जो है nature में, प्राकृतिक में exist करता है, present होता है, which I have explained you right now also when I was explaining the keywords, that is food chain. So the sequence of organism, the sequence of organism which in which it is being shown that each organism is dependent on the lower organism for its food. Okay, that is known as food chain. And this chain is also showing that how the plants and animals, they both are interdependent. Okay, they both need each other. Now, plants and animals help to maintain the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the environment by exchange of gases. Yes, this is depicted from this picture. You can see here in this picture, there is green plants, trees. Okay, small green plants are also there. Trees is also here. Then animals, human beings, they are also here. Okay, now this both plants and animals, they are helping in maintaining the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide gas in nature. मतलब एक संतुलन को, प्राकृतिक संतुलन को बनाए रखने में help करते हैं एक दूसरे की. कैसे? Because plants, they are doing photosynthesis, and during the photosynthesis they are giving out oxygen gas, and plants are also producing fruits, vegetables, other food items, cereals like rice, wheat, maize, etc. So this food and oxygen, it is being utilized by the animals, okay, by the human beings, by other animals even. Okay, so, and in return, the animals, they are giving out, or human beings, we are breathing out the carbon dioxide gas. When we exhale the carbon dioxide gas in the surrounding atmosphere, and that carbon dioxide gas is being utilized by the plants, green plants, for their photosynthesis process. Thus, this is the only balance which is being maintained by the plants and animals in our surrounding environment, in the natural environment. Okay, so that is the balance of, or exchange of gases also it is known as, because obviously there is the exchange going on. Exchange matlab adla badli, plants hame oxygen de rahe hain aur hum badle mein carbon dioxide de rahe hain. To plants jo oxygen de rahe hain wo hamare liye life saving gas hai. We cannot live without oxygen because we need oxygen to breathe in. Similarly, plants cannot do photosynthesis without carbon dioxide gas. Plants need carbon dioxide gas to complete the process of photosynthesis. Thus, this exchange of gases, that is the oxygen and carbon dioxide in the environment, in the nature, it is very important, and thus a balance is maintained in the nature by both the green plants as well as the animals or living organisms. Okay, so that's what it is written over here, ki plants and animals help to maintain the balance. Okay, santulan ko banai rakhna, balance means santulan, maintain means banai rakhna. किस चीज के बैलेंस को? ऑक्सीजन एंड कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इन द एनवायरमेंट. एनवायरमेंट मींस आवर सराउंडिंग, व्हाटएवर इट इज प्रेजेंट इन आवर सराउंडिंग एरियाज, वेदर इट इज सॉइल, वेदर इट इज एयर, वेदर इट इज प्लांट्स, एनिमल्स, रॉक्स, वाटर बॉडीज, एवरीथिंग इज आवर एनवायरमेंट बाय एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस. एंड वी हैव सीन द एक्सचेंज ऑफ गैसेस दैट द प्लांट्स, दे आर गिविंग ऑक्सीजन गैस, which animals are utilizing, and animals, they are breathing out, they are giving out carbon dioxide gas which the plants are utilizing for their photosynthesis process. Okay, now diagram of interdependence of plants and animals given in book page number 51 to be done by students themselves. So this diagram work also that is given in page number 51, this diagram, it is also very important because this diagram is depicting, it is showing interdependence of plants and animals. So this diagram also is to be drawn along with this answer. Next question is, what are the raw materials needed to make food? How plants obtain these raw materials? Yes, basically it is, the question is asking that what things the green plants need as raw materials, मतलब कच्चे substances, कच्चे material के तौर पे plants को क्या चाहिए होता है अपना खाना बनाने के लिए, and how plants obtain these raw materials, और पौधे कैसे raw materials को obtain करते हैं, पाते हैं, obtain means to get, so answer is sunlight, water and carbon dioxide are the raw materials a plant need for making food. So that was the first part of the question, कि what are the raw materials needed to make food needed by plants. Okay, obviously this question is about plants. So the raw materials which the plants need to make their food or basically to do the process of photosynthesis is, those raw materials are in the form of sunlight, water and carbon dioxide. So these are the raw materials which a plant need for making food. Okay, and how the plants are obtaining these raw materials? So plants obtain these raw materials in the following ways. So to get these raw materials, what the plants are doing? So first is, roots absorb water and minerals from the soil. Water and minerals are carried to the leaves through stem, through the stem. Obviously, the roots of the plants, they are growing in the soil, okay, below the soil. And from in the soil, we know nutrients, minerals, water, air, everything is present. So roots are absorbing, absorb matlab soak lena apne andar. तो रूट्स जो हैं वाटर और मिनरल्स को मिट्टी से एब्जॉर्ब कर लेते हैं एंड दिस वाटर एंड मिनरल्स दे आर कैरीड टू द लीव्स और वो पत्तों तक पहुंचाए जाते हैं कैरीड टू द लीव्स मीन्स उन्हें पहुंचाया जाता है पत्तों तक थ्रू द स्टेम पौधे की जो स्टेम होती है जो तना होता है वो उस चीज को वाटर और मिनरल्स को लीव्स तक पहुंचाने का काम करते हैं ओके सो दीज वर द रॉ मटीरियल्स दिस वाटर एंड मिनरल्स वॉज द रॉ मटीरियल for the leaves to making their food and how they are getting these raw materials. So roots absorb water and minerals from the soil which is then carried to the leaves through the stem. Next, carbon dioxide gas is absorbed from the air through stomata. Now how the they are getting carbon dioxide gas? So jo carbon dioxide gas it is naturally present in the surrounding air in our atmosphere because all the animals they are breathing out the carbon dioxide gas. So that carbon dioxide gas is being absorbed from the air. हवा से ही इस carbon dioxide gas को absorb कर लिया जाता है. किस कौन absorb करता है? Through stomata. And we know stomata are the tiny holes which is present on the lower surface of the leaves. तो जो stomata है वो carbon dioxide gas को absorb कर लेती है हवा से. From the surrounding air or atmosphere. Next is sunlight. Sunlight falling on the leaves is absorbed by chlorophyll. Yes. And we know chlorophyll is the green colored substance which is present in the leaves. Leaves appear green in color due to the presence of chlorophyll only. And chlorophyll performs this important task of absorbing the sunlight which is falling on the leaves. Jo bhi sunlight, sun ki heat or light jo patton par gir rahi hoti hai, patton par pad rahi hoti hai, wo kaun absorb karta hai? To patton mein, leaves mein jo chlorophyll name pigment is present, chlorophyll name chemical substance is present, that's only absorbing the sunlight falling on the leaves. Okay, so these are the raw materials which a plant, which the green leaves need to do their photosynthesis process. And this was the method that how the plants, they are obtaining this raw materials. Okay, one more diagram work is to be done, students, to be done by the students themselves. Matlab this diagram work is to be done by you people only, by the students themselves. From book page number 49, diagram is of well-leveled of photosynthesis. Let me check page number 49 of the science book. There this diagram is given. Yes, kids. Photosynthesis, page number 49. And this complete diagram, it is very important. You can see the green plants. You can see the roots of the plants that is growing in the soil. This is brown color is representing soil. Okay. So roots are absorbing in the soil water and minerals. They are naturally present. So roots absorb this water and minerals from the soil, which is then carried by the stem. This is the stem part of the plant. So this water, minerals, nutrients, this is carried, this is absorbed by the roots, which is then carried by the stem to the leaves. Okay. And the leaves, they are already having a stomata on the lower surface, and that stomata is absorbing the carbon dioxide gas from the air. And the leaves, they are having the green colored substance, that is chlorophyll. And chlorophyll is helping to absorb the sunlight falling on the plants. And by this, all this thing, the plants are able, green plants are able to do photosynthesis to make their own food. And during which, meanwhile, during that process, they are giving out oxygen gas in the surrounding atmosphere or air. Okay. So this is the diagram of photosynthesis process, which also you have to draw with answer number 7. Okay. And while you are doing diagram work, kids, always use crayon colors or pencil colors to color the diagram. Avoid using sketch pen or marker colors. Okay. So that's all for revision part of this chapter video. Okay. Now all the chapters of midterm syllabus I have covered in the revision videos. Watch the videos carefully, completely, and do prepare well for your exams. Okay. Practice well, study well. So that's all for today's class. Take care of your health, take care of your studies. Thank you for the class.